So what's the difference between high-fructose corn syrup and sugar? Even though it seems like high-fructose corn syrup is in every single food and drink wrapped in plastic, you can't find it for sale alone on the shelf. And since there's a little bit of mystery about this stuff, let's take a look at how different these two sweets are and settle this once and for all. High-fructose corn syrup made its big-time market debut in the 1970s due to new taxes on import sugars as well as subsidies on corn crops, making it a much cheaper sweetener than regular table sugar. Since then, it's become a pretty standard part of the American diet. High-fructose corn syrup doesn't come about naturally, but instead through a pretty advanced chemical process. Corn is milled down to produce cornstarch, which is then further broken down into corn syrup, a product that is almost entirely made up of a sugar called glucose. And while glucose is sweet, it isn't sweet enough to do the job. So in the lab, certain enzymes and acids are used to convert some of the glucose into fructose, which is significantly sweeter. So high-fructose corn syrup is a mixture of these two compounds that comes in different variations. Glucose and fructose are what are known as monosaccharides, the simplest kinds of sugars, and also the building blocks of the more complex disaccharides. Now, what's important to realize is that common table sugar, or sucrose, is a disaccharide made up of equal parts of glucose and fructose. High-fructose corn syrup comes in different concentrations for different products, but it's remarkably similar. The current scientific consensus is that there's almost no nutritional difference between the two. So when it comes to discussing health issues with sweets, it's much less about this than it is about this. When you eat either table sugar or high-fructose corn syrup, both inevitably send glucose and fructose into the bloodstream. Glucose charges our cells up with energy, while fructose gets involved with cholesterol and energy-storing glycogen production in the liver. One of the big problems with overconsumption of sweets is that they start interfering with our metabolism and even start playing games with our brain, confusing our sense of hunger and even our feeling of being full. The more sweets we eat, the more possible physical damage they can do to our bodies. Large amounts of fructose, for example, can do a number on your liver and has been directly linked to obesity, heart disease, and diabetes. The American Heart Association suggests that women limit themselves to 6 teaspoons of added sugar per day, while men limit themselves to 9. That's pretty drastic considering the average American consumes around 23 teaspoons a day. So the big takeaway from all of this is to put a cap on your sweets. It'll do you good in the long run. Now on the topic of sweets, check out this video about the chemistry of artificial sweeteners and this one on ice cream. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and we'll see you again soon.